Nothing sorts the sheep out from the goats as much as keeping a diary. There are some who can, and there are some who simply can't, like me. Some who will put all their thoughts and all their happenings into them, like Anne Frank. She was given a diary on one of her birthdays and wrote in it these words: "I hope I shall be able to confide in you completely, as I have never been able to in any one before, and I hope that you will be a great support and comfort to me." And I'm very glad that it's a comfort to me, Kenneth Williams, to learn that you always keep a diary. I mean, since when have you kept a diary?
Well, I think mine started, well, I know I started when I was 14. And there's a very different reason why I started at 14 and not before. I could tell you about that. That's another discourse entirely. But that quote of Anne Frank's, I think, really does say something very profound about the whole idea of committing things to a diary. The idea that it's therapeutic, that it's a counsellor who will never let you down, you know, someone who will never answer back, and to whom you can say everything. And in that sense, I think it's a very healthy thing to do. You know, a lot of people have maintained that it's rather introverted to sit writing about yourself. But of course, it doesn't have to be all like that. I mean, diaries can be sheer, you know, narratives of events.
But isn't it a dangerous thing to keep? I mean, aren't you worried that somebody is going to find your diary? And has anybody ever found your diary?
Oh, yes. The first one I kept, you see, was when I was 14. I was an apprentice draftsman. That's why I was going to say that's the reason why I kept a diary, because I think when I was at school, I did a lot of essay writing. They encouraged it, that kind of thing at school. And I was always writing at least one essay a week. I did a lot of writing. And then when I left school and became an apprentice, such a discipline was not being instilled at all. And so I found that I took up the diary then, quite deliberately, as a substitute for the essay, so to speak. And when I was keeping this diary, I was 14, as I say, I left it foolishly, and my parents found it. And I'd written in, "Spent boring evening with M and D," thinking the code, you see, Mum and Dad, would be fine, but it wasn't. My father attacked me in the morning, so I read it. "Boring, are we? I'm the one that keeps a roof over your head, you know. We're boring, thank you very much." So that warned me, and in future I kept it in a secure place.
Do you think that your diary keeping has changed?
Oh, enormously. For instance, this is the first one I ever kept. It's all a bit tatty now. You can see the size of it. I mean, it is a very small little pocket diary. And then it moves to that sort of size. And then we get into that sort of size. That only actually happened. That size became possible because Gordon Jackson bought it for me. He said, "These little ones you keep are ridiculous. You must have a proper diary," and gave me that one. And now I'm up to A4, which is this size. So you see, over the years, I could say to have become an addict about how much I actually put down.
But do you put in things that you can look back on about the theatre that will remind you of something and help you in some sort of a way?
Ah, yes. Now I put all that down. I mean, for instance, the entire rehearsals with Guinness doing the Phaedo farce and all the marvellous business that he added to scenes and the way he approached the business, the way he did all the things with the umbrella, which, you know, when he was introduced, the man gave him the umbrella and then he gave it to him back and then the man gave it to him back, and it was all very funny comedy business. All that I wrote down and said how it came about and how it was the encouragement of the producer, how much was definitely the initiative of the actor. Oh, one learned enormously by that. And when I came to do a Phaedo many, many years later, in fact, about 10, 20 years later, I went back to all that period and remembered all the things that Glenville was saying, he was directing then, about the fact that it should resemble, again and again, the silent film in its precision and absolute symmetry. You know, you couldn't afford any sort of... Well, what you do in high comedy, which is give innuendo and all kinds of inflections to lines, this was much more report, bang, crash, you know, and all riposte answers like that.
But then would somebody say, if you say you're not going to want them published after your death.
Mm.
I'm surprised to hear you say that. I'd have thought you might have thought you'd want your diaries published after your death.
Oh, I see. Oh, after death?
Yes.
Oh, I beg your pardon. I thought you meant published during
lifetime.
No.
Oh, no.
Oh, after death, yes. One wouldn't mind that at all. And one would hope very much that there would be a careful editor to take out spelling mistakes and, you know, the more naive, silly things, that you weren't revealed in too daft a light. Although I suppose it would be their business to judge that. They'd be objective, wouldn't they?
But wouldn't you worry about being unkind or catty?
Well, I wouldn't care. I wouldn't care at all then. I wouldn't be out of the way. I wouldn't mind it. I wouldn't mind it. And them saying, oh, well, he was a rotter to say a nasty thing like that. I wouldn't mind at all if I was out of the way. That's fine.
But do you think, for instance, political diaries have got any use to us?
Oh, yes. Because, don't you see, they've been of enormous interest to historians, giving them a picture of the time, fashion, manners, what people ate, how they behaved, what they wore, all those things. I mean, the Saint-Simon diaries are perfect examples of that, aren't they? They give us tremendous insight into the period, and such an intimate insight into the period that we'd never learned. The same with Pepys, and the same certainly with Boswell's account of Johnson. There are lovely things there, really lovely.
But, and by the way, when do you write in your
diary? I do my diary in the morning. I recollect in the morning. That's when I think I'm most tranquil. Very early, I get up quite early and consign to paper then all the things that I feel, you know, should be commented upon.
Why do you think people don't keep diaries, Kenneth?
Well, I think it's largely to do with the fact that they want the past to be past and not resurrected in any way. I mean, Olivier made this point in the article he wrote about the new series for ITV when he said, you know, that past productions, things he's been often involved in at the time and loved very much, having done them, they're finished. He doesn't want ever to go back. You know, it's finished, it's done. And I think a lot of people feel that about diaries and letters. They don't want to be reminded of them at all.